Larix Tuner is the ultimate tool for managing multiple Larix Broadcaster app instances. It lets you handle bulk licensing, control settings remotely, and apply licenses among Android and iOS devices. With features like real-time stream previews, detailed performance stats, and automatic backups, it's perfect for remote production workflows that require control over multiple devices. In this video, we'll walk you through its core features and show you how Tuner can help improve the remote production of live broadcasting. We assume that you've already purchased a Larix Tuner's license. If you have any issues, please refer to our Larix Tuner overview video. First, let's log into Larix Tuner account. Here we can see our active license covering several devices. On this page, we can see the number of activated devices and the license validity period. Notice that a single license can be used on any device and moved between several devices. We will add one more device now. Click on the Licenses menu, and then click on the license number. Copy the license key string to pass it to the Larix device. You can also use a QR code, but we show the case when a producer sends this license over Messenger or email. Now, grab a device with Larix Broadcaster. Navigate to Settings by tapping the gear icon, and then tap Larix Tuner. Tap Activate Larix Tuner and paste the license key. In a moment, the license is activated, and information about this device is passed to Larix Tuner. The newly registered device will appear in Tuner's UI shortly. Now we see two activated devices on the Tuner page. Switch to Larix Broadcaster. Tap on Settings, go to the Larix Tuner menu, and find Pass Control to Larix Tuner button in the Remote Control section. This will initiate the remote control session. Back in the preview, you'll notice the yellow message saying Remote Control Active. Go to the Tuner panel and see that the device is under control now. The green icon and online status imply it. Click on the device name to go to the control panel. This is Larix Broadcaster's control center. Here you can have interactive control over the device running Larix. This allows making changes to any settings and overlays remotely, as well as looking at the live preview of the stream. At the Settings tab, all the parameters from Larix Broadcaster settings are duplicated. First, it's connections. Here's where you add, edit, or enable connection for a streaming session. Next one is TalkBack settings, to add and enable TalkBack connection to communicate with the producer via audio channel. Moving on to camera, set your resolution, orientation, frame rate, and camera options. Then there's video, specify codec, fine-tune bitrate and key frame rate to keep your stream sharp and smooth. Under audio, you'll find options to control sound. Choose audio input, adjust input gain, and select the best bitrate for your setup. Audio-only mode is also enabled here. Go to Recording to activate local recording, check storage options, and enable log file recording. Finally, the Advanced menu holds all tweaks, like the number of simultaneous connections, reconnect options, SEI, and RTMP HEVC format. Let's try to add a connection to stream in YouTube Live. Go to the Connections tab, click the Add Connection button, copy and paste the publishing point URL and a stream key from YouTube. Name a connection, mark it as active, and save it. This connection is sent to remote Larix once the sync is complete. Convenient, isn't it? The sync status is seen at the top left corner. To show how the overlays work, we're adding footage from a real device. Click on Overlays and Widgets. On this page, you can see the overlays available on the current device. They can be toggled by the switches in the active row. Let's click on Logo Overlay, and after a sync time, it'll appear on the device. Now edit by the pencil icon. The settings are exactly the same as they are in Larix instance, including the Z order. Let's add a web widget with a chat. We assume you know your own chat URL. Click Add Widget, paste the URL of a widget, and modify a position or other available options. Like we clicked Shrink to Fit here. Make it active and save. As the sync is complete, the chat will appear. If not, make sure the active is enabled on the widget. Most common control tasks are grouped in the Control Panel tab, Here we can start a stream or put it in standby or pause mode. Turning off the screen of a device and muting its mic is also here. Click to see how it's disabled on the remote device. Next is one of the exciting features of Larix Tuner, which is the remote device's content preview. This WebRTC-powered feature lets you see how you set up your device before streaming, so you can be sure everything is ready to go. Using WebRTC can be a bit tricky, depending on your network settings. That's why we've added different modes to get the feed from your device. If you're in a local network, just use Local Networks mode. If you're not sure, or you're on an external network, you can use All Networks or External, respectively. You can also save some bandwidth by using the video-only or audio-only feed in the tuner and also setting a lower resolution. Additionally, you can select the exact camera to stream to capture content. Here, we hooked cameras from an iPhone to our iPad. The internal camera exposure and zoom values can be tweaked. There's also an audio section to select audio sources. Click the Preview button to start a remote preview. The green message on the device confirms that the remote preview has started, and a picture appears on Tuner's page. Now it's time to roll the camera. Find a big green button on the top of the page and click it. A few moments are required to sync with the device, and here we see it streaming live. This device's screen shows that the stream is being published. On the respective YouTube Live page, the stream is received fine. Next, we can send some commands to the device while streaming. Navigate to the zoom slider and drag it. The device accepts the command after the sync is complete. It also affects the resulting stream. Now let's enable chat overlay. Navigate to the Overlays tab, find the required one, and enable the active switch. A few seconds are needed for the sync, and we see chat messages starting to appear. Oh, the time doesn't fit here. Let's switch it off. Back to the control page. We see the stream is running, but we want to make sure that the network is stable. The analytics data is ready and is tailored to meet your needs. Click on Active Session Statistics to get a rich, real-time report of your streaming session. Here we can see a round-trip time, or RTT for short, network drops, and dropped or failed connections. By the way, YouTube shows that the stream is healthy, but it doesn't provide any insights. Now let's try to pause the stream. Did you know that Larix Broadcaster has a feature for "we'll be right back" or private situations? It's specified by the picture overlay, which is marked as pause image. Let's try this mode. The stream won't be broken, and the pause image will be streamed instead of the actual stream data. Simply click the pause button on the control panel page. The pause image will appear in the stream. Click resume to show the camera's view in a stream again. It's time to stop a stream by clicking the red stop button. As we see, the remote Larix stopped the stream and YouTube indicates that it has stopped receiving data and will stop the stream soon too. Once the stream is done, we need to give the device control back to the operator. Look for the crossed red button and click it. Then click stop to confirm that we're done with the control session. On the devices page, we see no online status for the device that we've just controlled. When we check the device, we can see it stores every setting that was modified during a remote session. Here's the connection and overlay we've added. That's all for now. With Larix Tuner, managing multiple devices and creating smooth, high-quality live streams has never been easier. From activating licenses to fine-tuning settings, previewing streams, and monitoring performance in real time, Larix Tuner is a great tool for professional live broadcasting. You can find more information about Larix Tuner and its features in the description. Thanks for watching, and happy streaming!